Latin, the more Dagon cruisers of Latin formation.
They got a lock on us.
They've moved into boarding position, Captain.
Prepare to engage a quantum neutralizer. Stand by.
Shields down.
Yes, we'll drop.
I sure hope you know what you're doing.
So do I, Lieutenant. So do I. Are you drawing cartoons?
No. Looked like cartoons to me.
I'm writing a comic novel. Actually, they're completely different things.
My dad doesn't let me read anything with pictures. He said if a book got pictures, the writing's clearly not good enough. He stopped reading to me when I was six. When did your parents stop reading to you?
They didn't.
What, they still read to you?
No.
They never read to you at all?
I don't remember anything about my parents. If you excuse me.
Splattering all over the walls, dripping into the mossy ground, pouring into the dark, dank hole in the ground.
There lived a princess, and her name was Princess Bubblegum. She was head of the Candy Kingdom in the land of Oo, which is in the land of O.
I was very nervous of all the big children like you, 10 and 11. But as time went by, I found out that they were more scared of us than we were of them.
Ah! She screamed as the tarantula crawled out of her tub. She flipped it up and carried on running.
She had discovered a land of fairies, but they were very
Captain
gasped.
Turned to his crew and shouted, "Laser cannon, zip to phase 7. Lieutenant, assemble a crew." But before they could assemble, there was another explosion on the ship.
Direct hit, sector 9.
Damage report! 80%, Captain.
I'm gonna hold out much longer.
Engines 9, 7, and 4 all gone, Captain.
Captain, the lower deck's in flames.
If you don't act fast, it will take over the whole ship.
Orbega, can you still operate the hull doors?
Yes, Captain.
Ava, clear the decks.
Yeah, ma'am!
Paranon, can you still fly this thing?
Yes, Captain.
Prepare to jump to Kern 12.
You mad? You gonna get us all killed?
Kern 12!
The doors open?
Yes, ma'am.
Paranon, dive!
Kern 9. Kern 10.
Fire on deck, 3 neutralized.
Close the doors!
Doors closing.
Turn 12.
We're falling too fast.
Turn 20. Turn 14.
Great!
They're not cartoons, it's a comic, okay?
Look, I'm sorry about earlier.
Look, I don't like to talk about it.
No, that's fine. What school did you go to?
St. Mary's.
Never heard of it.
It's a home. Look, if you wouldn't mind.
said need to go.
More Dagons and Bar Dagons, don't they sound very similar?
That was my line! That was it, took me ages!
Awesome, I know two other people from my schools.
Look, just leave me alone. Keep a secret.
Depends what it is.
What's that?
I don't know, I just found it.
I wonder what this button does.
We're getting a reading on the neuronizer, Captain.
Can you get an exact fix?
Negative. They're projecting towards the planet in the firing quadrant. It could be anywhere.
Any signs of life? There appears to be a large number of life forms reported. The dominant species aren't too different to our own. Atmosphere? High level of oxygen and numerous other gases. It should be breathable.
But if we leave anyone down there for too long, it may just trigger their aging process.
I wonder what life must be.
Captain, we've managed to get a lock on the Mordagon craft.
Bearing?
Sub-Delta 9.
Then they're on a direct course towards...
Lieutenant, get a squad together.
We're going in.
Carrie.
Thank you. Zuvalin, I've got it. Open the portal. Now.
Scanning now. Okay, I found something. There appears to be a small quadrant in the next floor down.
Okay.
Careful. It looks like there is a droid down there. I'm getting a reading now.
Like where?
She's directing you to the broom cupboard.
Room what?
I know where it is. Come on, I'll show you. It's this way.
You may as well save the play.
Zuvalin, where's the portal?
You need to activate the quantum neutralizer.
It's not working.
It must do.
I'm telling you, it's not working!
Captain, I think it's broken.
Zuvalin, we have a problem.
Electronics room?
So what is that thing?
A quantum neutralizer has the power to manipulate time and space, kid.
What, is it like a time machine?
No. It allows you to undo previous events. Like an eraser to your past.
Like anything?
Like anything. If it falls into the hands of the Mordagans, that's it.
Done.
Let's go.
I knew in that moment that this was my destiny. that everything that had happened in my life, to that point, both good and bad, was all leading up to this. The fate of the universe was resting in my hand.
Absolutely amazing. Well done, Luke.
That was stupid.
Yeah.
Why didn't they just restart the time thingy?
The quantum neutralizer doesn't work like
then
that.
Then it doesn't make sense, does
Let's
it?
Let's try and keep our comments positive, shall we?
But it's stupid.
I actually think it's a really good idea. Lots of really creative ideas.
Why would they take you? Like, you could fly a spaceship.
That's why I couldn't go straight away. They had to download the data directly into my brain. It takes a while to sink
in. Miss, he just nicked that from the Matrix. I'm sure it's meant to be more of a homage to the Matrix, a kind of appreciation. Isn't that right, Luke?
No.
Why would they give you a portal?
Quantum neutralizer.
Whatever. Why didn't they just take him on their ship and download the information there?
It's not that straightforward. They have to program the reset first.
Program the reset?
So when I leave, everything will return back to normal.
When were you ever normal?
It'd be a bit odd if I just suddenly disappeared, wouldn't it? As soon as I step through that portal and they activate the reset, any memories or traces of me vanish.
That will do, thank you. Carrie, would you like to read your story now?
When I was a little girl, I believed in fairies. I knew without a shadow of a doubt that fairies were real. They lived in a magical world, but sometimes they were able to cross over and visit us. I would stay up late in my room, watching out the window, waiting for a glimpse, because I knew that if I watched and waited long enough, I would get to see one. But I never did, and one day I just stopped believing. It happens to everyone. We all have to grow up someday. We all have to accept that magic and the supernatural just don't exist. For some it happens quickly, like when you catch your parents putting presents out at Christmas and realise that there is no Santa. And with others, it creeps up slowly. Bit by bit, it crumbles away until everything you once believed in fades away. It is a little sad, but it is okay. It just means that we are growing up, that we are moving on to the next part of our lives. One day we all have to stop believing in fairies.
Broom cupboard.
Miss, can I have the key for the cupboard? I'm collecting garbage at break. I need garbage bags.
Straight
back. I know I said it was stupid, but after you explained it, it all made perfect sense. So, where exactly is this portal, or cupboard, whatever you want to call it?
Well, it's just a story.
Oh, but it's so much more than just a story. You see, there's one major plot hole. A key.
something went wrong. He's not there. Okay. Reset the hyperdrive.
Yeah.